morning. It is December the 19th, 2016, and it is episode number 19 of the Knit-Nix podcast. I'm broadcasting here in Calgary, Alberta, Canada, and I'm Carla, also known as Knit-Nix. You can find me as Knit-Nix on Ravelry and as Carla Jean on Instagram. And today I'm flying solo. The last two or three episodes I've been filming with Leslie, but today I am flying solo because she is just in the midst of trying to get ready for Christmas. She just finished school yesterday, but has lots to do and needs to get ready for Christmas. I've been busy the last month. Let's see, from November 14th till now, lots has happened to me. I had a birthday in there, and I was spoiled rotten. And also in there, I've been preparing for Christmas. And this past weekend, we had our kids in, and we had our kids' Christmas, where we exchange gifts. We draw names and exchange gifts, and I give them stockings and, of course, some cash, as that's what every kid wants. Anyhow, it is a beautiful day outside. It's been very cold in Calgary, and it's been like hovering around minus 25 with wind chill, and today it is just below freezing, so it feels balmy, but it's gray, and it looks like it's kind of wanting to snow a little bit, but we're happy to have a little snow if we can say goodbye to the freezing cold temperatures. I am celebrating an anniversary tomorrow. It's going to be my 8th anniversary, and I'm not even sure what we're doing yet, but I have the day off, and I'm going to possibly, I don't know, go for dinner or something with my husband, so that's kind of exciting. But let's get on to some knitting and what's happening in the knitting realm here. Like I said, I got spoiled on my birthday, so my girlfriend Carmen, who I speak about a lot on my show here, she gifted me two beautiful project bags, two just like this one, and these are housing my socks right now. But anyway, they are absolutely gorgeous. The socks are in the other one. This one's empty, but in the other one, which is exactly just like this one, I'm housing some of my socks that are my works in progress. On the weekend of my birthday, a good friend of mine that I met in Sorrento this year, her name is Vicky, and her and I and Carmen did a little bit of I guess yarn crawling. We actually went only to two yarn stores in Calgary. We went to the Loop and to Stash Lounge in Inglewood. And I had a lot of fun. I thought, since it's my birthday, I can buy a few things. So I ended up getting nothing at the Loop. I just wanted her to show that's my local yarn shop. But I rarely go to Stash Lounge. And at Stash Lounge, I acquired some yarn that was on sale for a really great price. I'm just going to check the bill here. They were priced at $2.50 a ball, and I got two of them in this color. They were 50% off. This is called, I don't know if you can read that, Diamond Luxury, and it is a, what weight is this? I think it looks to me like a light worsted or a DK, and I also bought a pom-pom, and I thought I would make a cable hat or two out of this. And I also bought the same yarn, only in a periwinkle color. And I thought, this is a color that I love to wear, that I could make a sweater for myself out of this. And I bought enough to make a whole sweater. So I bought 9 skeins. And the whole price on that was $22.50. So I got enough to make a sweater. And the cost will be $22.50. So that, I thought that was really good. So those are some of my purchases, and also I bought a pair of bamboo hi-hias, 9-inch circulars. Never tried these ones, so I thought I'd give them a go. I like 9-inch circulars, but I've never tried the hi-hia bamboo, so I bought a pair of those, and that was my birthday weekend. Yeah, I got spoiled rotten by my kids, went for breakfast with my girls, and I had breakfast with my son alone. We did our own little thing. And went for dinner with my husband, and dinner with Carmen and Brent, And so, yeah, I got really spoiled. And that's back in November. So that was, gosh, like 3 weeks ago now. Anyway, so that's my acquisitions for this last month. And so let's talk about what's on the sticks. And on the sticks, I have my socks that in episode 18, Leslie and I dyed sock blends. And I've really enjoyed it, and I've been posting my progress on Instagram. But it's a really great yarn that she's got. I think it's called BFL, a blue-faced Leicester or whatever. It's BFL, and it feels really squishy. And the sock blank I knit up, here's what's left of it, because I'm about halfway through it. You can see it was upside down. Anyway, so this is the sock blank that I'm knitting from, and it's kind of festive. And we went through the whole process in episode 18, if you wanted to look back on that. And I, this is my progress. I'm using a pattern called Socks on the Plane. It's a free pattern on Rav. And I'm doing two at a time on 9-inch circulars. And here they are. Now this doesn't really do it justice. Should actually put them on a, but there, that's better. So yeah, it's really knitting up really cool. It's striping. And because she made these sock blanks double-stranded, the socks are knitting up identical. So they're kind of, as she called them, I think she called them a hot mess. Anyway, they're really coming out quite nicely. And I've done the heel, and this was a different heel. Not sure I like it because of the color change. I should have maybe made it more, but anyway, that's the heel on that pattern. It's a different one. It's a short row heel, and it's from the toe up. And so I'm just going to finish up now by, you know, going up here another 4 or 5 inches, and then I will put the red top on the top. Oh, and there's a story about that. Shortly after our last episode, I said to Leslie, I said, you know, I really want some skeins of your little mini skeins of real Christmas colors. And I was talking to her, and she goes, did you get that yet? Did you find them? And I said, find them? What do you mean? And she says, go look outside. And she says, I'm going to give you a hint. She says, squirrel. So I'm going, squirrel, tree. So I went out. It was pitch black in my backyard. I went out to the backyard, and I think I have a picture here, and I'll insert it. Anyway, I go out to the back, and hanging in my tree are 3 skeins of minis in a green, a red, and she did the teal as well. She did up so that she said, why don't you do different heels, toes, and tops in the 3 different colors? But anyway, she, in the middle of the day, came to my house, kind of creepy. She climbed the tree, and she hung 3 skeins in my tree. And she said the nanny next door was like looking at her like she had lost her head. But that's Leslie. She was just being silly, and she gifted me 3 skeins, but I had to really work for them. I was up there climbing in the middle of the night. Well, it was about 10 o'clock at night, pitch blackout, and I only could manage to get 2, and then the next morning my husband went out and got the 3rd one. But what a character. But yes, so I got 3 skeins from Leslie. So that's what I'm doing these with. I'm doing same kind of yarn. She just dyed them up in festive coordinating colors. But anyway, that's the socks that are on that sticks. That's my current project, because I really want to wear these on Christmas morning. So anyhow, so moving on here, let's see what else I've got on the sticks here. Oh yes, I am working on a pair of socks for my son-in-law, because he said that he would like them for Christmas. But of course, he's in the army, and his battalion colors are maroon and gold. So I'm making him, I just started them. They're in another bag, in Carmen's bag, as a matter of fact, which I don't have at the table. But here's the color choices that I've chosen. His colors are maroon and gold, but I thought more manly, a sock that he could wear in his hiking boot or his army boot. would be maroon and black. So I've done the tops in black so far, and I just started in on the red. And I'm just doing a plain vanilla sock. So that's one thing I'm working on. Unfortunately, he won't be getting it for Christmas. He's got a birthday in April, and that's probably when he will get those socks. Let's see, I've been working on another pair of socks, which I will like to call my forever socks because I've been working on them forever. But I finished the one, and I'm just about to put in, not quite yet, about another couple inches. I've only done about this much since the last episode. But I'm good. This is the Susan B. Anderson smooth operator socks. So I'm just about to put in the heel, but I haven't quite done that yet. So anyway, a little progress on those. And let's see here. Oh yes, I know what I've got here. I did, on my last episode with Leslie, showed you that I was working on some cabled mittens, and I changed colors because I ran out, and then I decided that I didn't like the look of the mittens, so I tore back the cabling a little bit, and I decided that I'm going to finish them up as fingerless mittens. So I shortened the pattern and I added a ridge on them, and so this project is now fingerless mittens. So I just finished the one, and then I can cast on, I'm about to cast on the second one. And this is a free Ravelry pattern. I will insert the name here, but something to do with berries. But anyway, it's a mitten pattern, and I just ended it here, and then I added an inch. One by one ribbing. And this yarn is a Patton's, it's called Chunky Tweeds. And it was just in my stash that I had kicking around, and I didn't quite have a full ball. That's why I couldn't quite make a full pair of mittens, but I'm gonna really enjoy these. They're warm and they'll be nice and kind of fun. And if I finish the other one, I will possibly gift them to somebody for Christmas. That's something I'm working on. What else do I have going here?
Yes, I did.
Oh, I found it here. There it is. It's in. There's the sock that I told you about for my son-in-law. So I've just did the black on the top, and for his army battalion colors, the maroon. I'm going to do the socks in maroon. So again, that's something that'll be a slow go because it's not needed to be done until April. I think other than my shawl that I was working on for Lisa, which I haven't done any work on, the Foggy Beach. I'm still working on that. I haven't done any progress since the last time we spoke, but I will at least show it to you. It's lovely, and I'm going to enjoy it, but I haven't done anything on it, and I'm sorry, Lisa. My Christmas knitting has kind of taken priority, so I will work on that in January in the new year, or over Christmas after the Christmas rush is over. So yeah, and what do I have off the sticks? I've only got one project off the sticks, and it is these socks. These were Forever and Ever Amen, and these are ones I started in on the island when we were away this August. And these are, again, a plain vanilla sock with an Eye of the Partridge heel and 2x2 ribbing on the top. And Kitchener toes, just real basic socks that I am going to possibly give away at Christmas, but I'm not sure. And that is it for my what's off the sticks. And yeah, that is it. I just also, before I close off and edit, I just wanted to show my yarn basket that I created. I crocheted this. It is made out of my very first hand spun that I made on my for my birthday spinning wheel. And so all the reddish coloring here is my hand spun. And then I thought I would use up scraps of yarn that had wool content. I used creams, greens, and beiges, and I crocheted it up, and then I gave it a great big well, actually several baths in an agitating washing machine, and it felted it. And now it houses my beautiful yarn, and it makes a really great Christmas decoration. So I've forgotten to mention that, and I just wanted to mention that before I edited and closed off this video. I did meet up just the other day with my friend Kim Nelson, Ginger Snap, and I purchased something for my niece, and I don't think she watches, so I'm going to risk it. Her parents asked me to get two knitting bags for her because she's a little shawl and sock knitter, and I got these for her, and these are from Kim. They're lovely. This one is, I think, called Birch Trees. There's birch trees, and it's got a little woodpecker on this side. It's really lovely. And she does such nice detailing. Look at this. There's her little label and her little pull. And, oh, and inside is kind of a red, I don't want to say it almost looks tie-dyed. And she puts a nice red zipper, and it's got a little kind of cord pull on it. Little leather pull. Is that leather? Pleather or leather? Anyway, it's lovely. So she picked the head of the woodpecker as the accent color for her zipper and her inside. So that's the one. And then this is more of a sock one. Oh, and this is really cool. This one's called Sea Turtles. And this one is got a really cute little pull on it under the sea pull. And again, she's got a little, I don't know what you call that, but a place to put, you could hang stitch markers off that. And this one doesn't have her name on it. What do you know? But the inside is, looks like ocean with gold. It's really pretty on the inside. So yeah, really gorgeous. She does beautiful, beautiful work. So that's from Kim, Ginger Snap That. And she does lovely work. And those are going to be gifted. Well, I bought them for my brother and his wife to give to their daughter for Christmas. And then she also, as she always seems to do, is she gave me a bunch of little things to have as giveaways, which will be on future episodes. She gave me a white chocolate stash tea, a little green pencil, and she gave me some stitch markers. I should put my glasses on so I can read these. Oh, changing different glasses here. This one is, oh, a set of stitch markers. And they look like they are, oh, angel wings and little beads. See the little kind of a winged there? Little angel wings with the little diamonds and rhinestones. And then little gold or bronzy beads for stitch markers. And this one says, Knitting Diva. Really cool. So that's a progress keeper. That, and then she gave me a little, two little things. She gave me a bag. Looks like, almost looks Harry Potter-ish, but I'm not sure what the name of this one is. But anyway, it's got inside of, yeah, it looks like it could be like a Harry Potter wizardry one. And it's got like, it almost looks like constellations or stars on it. Can't really tell, but anyway, it says it would be enough a bag for either notions or a small pair of socks. And then she gave me a Christmassy tartan little notions pouch, so very Christmassy. So anyway, that's cool. And that's from Kim again, from Ginger Snap That. So thanks, Kim. I'm not going to do a giveaway until the new year, and when I'm back with my good friend Leslie, we're going to do an episode probably in the new year. Oof, these are awful. Anyway, not much to talk about here. Christmas time, we are going to be here for Christmas, and then we're heading off to Palm Springs to spend time alone. My husband and I are just the two of us, so I'm really looking forward to that. We're going to go until early January, January 9th or so. And just to get away, every time we go down to Palm Springs, we normally have friends down there that meet with us. So we're really looking forward to having just the two of us down there for this one time. But again, in January, end of January, and we're going back to do the MS, not MS, sorry, we're going to do the Tour de Palm Springs. So we're going back for a kind of like 4 or 5 days. And then my friend Carmen, her husband Brent, are coming, and they're going to go a little bit earlier than us and stay a little bit later than us. So that's going to be nice for them. So looking forward to that as well. But I am truly looking forward to spending some quiet time with my husband at Christmas away in the warmth of good old Palm Springs. Anyway, I'm going to call it a wrap. This is just a little check-in before Christmas. I've been really neglectful and haven't been podcasting, but I just wanted to get one out there before the Christmas rush. And I just want to wish you and yours a very Merry Christmas, or if you're not Christian or whatever, it's season's greetings to all of you, and I hope you're happy and healthy and get to spend some time with your loved ones, whoever they may be. And take care, and we will see you next year. And I think in January, Miss Leslie and I will podcast together. But I just wanted to say hello, and we'll talk soon. Take care. Bye-bye now.
Snow falls, covers all. Let's go outside and have a ball. Slide down a hill, let's build a snowman in this winter wonderland. Families meet, friends we greet, to ring in Christmas cheer. That's why, for me, it's my favorite time of the year. On Christmas Eve.